Hey, hello, grade 11s. My name is Joy from Joy T Academy. And I just want us to go through these theorems. And my plan is to go through them one by one now. So the next video, we know that we go through the problems. Okay? Theorem number one. Theorem number one says you need a center and you need a chord. Okay? A chord is AB. Okay? They normally say, let's say you have a center O, and then they say a line that is drawn from the center to this chord and is drawn perpendicular. They say just know that, and here at this point, maybe they give you D, okay? This line from the center drawn perpendicular to the chord makes AD to be equal to BD. Okay? That is a message. Okay? This tells you this. Okay? Let me repeat. This line drawn perpendicular tells you that AD is the same as DB or BD. Okay, it's up to you. You can say AB and DB, or you can say AB, BD. Okay, so this is a message from this, nothing special. Okay, don't overthink it. Once you see a line coming here, and then maybe they give you 16 here, they said AB 16, just know, oh, which means here I have what? I have 8, and here I have 8 from this 16. If they say AB is 8, just know, oh, I have 4 here, and I have 4 here. Okay? And if they give you AD, they say AD is 2, so which means this portion is 2, and then they will ask you to find AB. Just know, oh, to find AB, which means this one is the same as this. So the whole length is what? You multiply by 2, then you get what? You get 4. AB is 4. Okay? So this is the idea. Okay? This is the idea behind this. Okay? Let's go for theorem 2. Theorem 2 says, you have a center, okay, and you have a chord, okay? You have a center and you have a chord. Okay. Now, and that chord creates an angle at a center. Okay. Okay, this is an angle at the center. Okay, this chord, lines from this chord are forming what? Are forming an angle at the center. This theorem says if the same chord is forming an angle at circumference now. Okay, remember, the same chord formed this angle. And the theorem says, if that chord is also forming what? An angle circumference. That angle circumference is half of this angle. In other words, this is O. This is angle C. Okay? In other words, angle at the center is double or is 2 times an angle or at what? At circumference. Let me repeat this. Okay? This theorem, think of theorem as a rule. Okay? This theorem says you have a chord AB. That chord is creating, or that chord is forming, an angle at the center. Now it says, if that chord, that same chord, is also forming an angle at the circumference, there is a relationship between that angle at the center and the one at the circumference. Okay? The relationship is this. The angle at the center is 2 times the angle at where? At circumference. In other words, the angle at the center is double. Okay? Remember, they won't ask you to explain all this, but it's very important to know. Because what I'm telling you is what is the formula that we are going to use when you are working with these angles. Okay? Because angle O is equal to 2 times angle C. Okay? Do you see that? This is what we are going to use when you see something like this all the time. When they gave you this one, you put it here. Then you divide by 2 to find C. If they gave you this one, you just put it here. You multiply by 2, you get your O. Okay? It is very important, this one. What is your reason? Your reason will be always the reality, what is going on. You always say angle at center. I don't have a space now. At center is equal to 2 times angle at circum. Okay? Angle at center is equal to 2 times angle at circum. This is it. Angle at center is O, is equal to 2 times angle at circumference. That's C. Okay, now we are done. I'm passing. I had to draw this one. Why? It's because we have 3 types of this theorem. Okay? And I want you to pay attention. If it's not this one, they will give you this one. It's the same thing and same reason. Okay? This one, yes. This one doesn't change. Okay? Number 2, we have to pay attention to this. Let me put it like this. This time I'm not putting a chord. They can put a chord, they can use an arc. Okay. Now we have arc A, B. If you don't know what arc is, you look at this. Arc is just small part of what? Of the circumference. Small piece, nyanaj. Okay. A small piece, nyana, of what? Of this circle. What are you going to do with this? They will say the arc AB subtends an angle at center O. Okay? Arc AB form what? Form an angle where? At center O. It's the same thing. They can put this one here. If they didn't put it, they can use A, B, and we call it A, B, an arc. Okay, an arc. Okay, now, remember, the first one was going straight up. Straight up. Look at this one. This one, instead of going straight up, this one will go this direction. Okay? Not up, up. Okay? We'll just go like this. Remember, this line is coming from A. So we need a line that is coming from B for you to say, oh, this is theorem 2. If lines are not doing this, if lines are not coming from the same point, don't even think of this. This is your C now. They can do this even this side. Okay? They can make these theorems even 3. They can 1, 2, 3. But the relationship is still the same. Okay? Here, angle at the center is still equal to 2 times angle at circumference, because C is at circumference. Can you see that? O remain the same. O remain the same. O angle O remain the same there at the center. Then this one is just changing position. It's, remember, it's not about how far, which side, you know, up, down, where. They say, this theorem says, angle at the center is double the angle circumference, not on the left, not on the right. As long that angle is created or is formed or is subtended by the lines from the same points as this one, and is at circumference. Now we are winning. It still fall under this one, under this theorem. Okay, the last one, because like I said, we have three of these. The last one says, again, you need what? You need a center. Okay, the first one at the center is still there. Okay, it's still there. It's still there. So, an arc is forming angle O. Okay, arc A, B. But remember, the first one, the first version of this one was going up. Okay? The second one went this side. It can go this side or this side, but didn't go up. It's just, you know. The third one is not even going to that side. It's just going down. Okay? It's just going down. I repeat. It's just going down. This is still the same theorem. Okay? We have this angle now. We have this angle now. This one is still where? At circumference. It's still at the circumference. Okay. But what makes this one kind of unique from the other two? The angle that is doubling is the one that is outside. Okay? I want you to pay attention to that one. Here, yes, we are still saying the same thing, but the one that we are using is this. They normally trick you. They will give you this. Remember, these are the angles around the point, which means this side and this side, they will give you 360. If they give you maybe 120 here, then outside they give you X. You say X plus 120 is equal to 360. Why? Angles around the point. And then you get your answer. The one that you get is the one that is double this one. Okay? But our O is still 2 times C. But now this time is the one this side, not this side. Okay, let's go for theorem 3. The third one says, you have the chord here. Remember, they can say a chord or an arc. Okay, which means if there's no chord, you look the points. Oh, this is your arc. Your angles must come from here, or the lines that are going to form angles. Okay, they must come from the same point for you to say this one is working. So now, this one doesn't need a center to survive, okay? This one says you have a chord, and that chord is subtending, and that chord subtends or form angles at the circumference, okay? You have this one, okay? Let's say this is angle. Okay, let me just put this. This theorem says if the same chord is forming another angle. On the same side. Those angles are equal. As long that chord is forming angles at a circumference on the same side, those angles are equal. Okay? It doesn't matter even if they are what? There are three, there are four. Okay? This one is still equal. Okay, it doesn't matter. Let me add another one here. As long, it's just that when these things they are put together, they are very confusing, very confusing. Just a matter, you have to analyze them. Okay? If this is angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D, what are you gonna say? This is going to be angle A is equal to angle B, angle C equal to angle D. Okay? So what would be your reason? This depends on the book that we are using. Okay? Some books, they say chord subtends equal angles. Okay? Chord subtends equal angles. Some books will say angles on the same segment. What is a segment? Segment, please go back and check my previous video on this one. I was explaining the terms and the meanings of this small part of a circle. Okay, so, but the segment is this part of a circle. Okay, how the segment is formed? This chord is splitting or dividing a circle into two parts. Okay, there's this bigger part from here upward and this one. We call these parts segments. This is a small segment or minor segment. This is a major segment or bigger segment. Okay, so some books will say angles on a same segment. Segment. This is your reason. Or some, they will say chord subtends. Subtends means formed, creates. Okay, subtends, but that's a term. Subtends. Subtends what? Subtends equal chords. Sorry. Subtends equal angles. Okay, chord subtends equal angles. Okay, let me write here. Chords, chord sub tens what equal angles. This can be your reason, or angles on the same segment. Okay. Because after saying they are equal, why are they equal? You say these are what? Angles on the same segment. Or you say chord subtends equal angles. It's really up to you. You know which one is easier now. Okay? Let me know which one sounds better. Let me know what you think is easier for you or you will remember. Because my main problem in high school, I had no problem with finding angles. The problem was to give a reason why I'm saying this is equal. Even if I know this is equal, but now I don't know how to put a reason. You know, end up losing marks there and there and stuff. So now, let's go for the next theorem. The next theorem, it doesn't need a center, okay? Again, it doesn't need a center. It just needs the chords, four chords. It's made up of four chords. Four chords, yeah. It's made up of four chords, but now they are forming a very strange shape. A very strange shape. Why I'm saying the chords? Because this is what will happen. Okay, all these lines are touching what? Are touching circumference, this side and this side. But they are what? They are connecting. They are not forming a triangle. They are forming a quadrilateral. Okay? They are forming a quadrilateral. Okay? They are forming a quadrilateral. Now, this one says, come on, here they just tell us something. You just have to grab it and live with it. Simple. Okay, I know it doesn't sound easy as I think it is. But I believe it's not that difficult as well. Okay, they are just telling us here. But okay, if you have something like this, you see a very, but don't worry. But now, we have to master this while he's still alone like this. Because in your exam, they will mix these theorems and you can't even find the shape. Okay? You just have to follow what they ask you. Okay? If you have A here, and you have B here, and C, C, and D, and all these points are touching the circumference, then this means is what? This is what? Is a cyclic quad or a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay. So what is it about it? Okay, now we know. If chords are meeting each other like this, but yeah, chords, for the chords to be the chord, must touch the what? The circumference. That's why I'm calling these chords, just that they are forming a very scary shape or strange one. Okay, so what is it about it? They say now, the opposite angles add up to 180. Okay, the opposite angles, let me do them. I'll give them 2 and 2. They are not equal. They are not equal. Okay, I'm just giving this just for you to know, okay, these ones is working together with this one. Okay, this one is what? It's what we call a cyclic quad. Okay, a cyclic quad. Quad. Okay. When they say A, B, C, D is a quad, is a cyclic quad, just know, oh, okay, they are telling me what A, B, C is touching the circumference number 2, and the opposite angles, they add up to 180. Opposite A and C are opposite. Okay, so angle A plus angle C, they add up to 180. Okay. Even if they say proof, that's what we are proving. The proof here, when they say proof, this is a cyclic quad, what are you gonna do? You prove this. Are the opposite side adding up to 180 or not? If no, run, brother, run. But especially if you know you didn't make a mistake. But if you didn't make a mistake, okay, you have to do it again. Okay, again, angle B plus angle D is equal to 180. That's what this rule is telling us. This is exactly this rule is telling us, or this theorem is telling us. These theorems, they're like rules. Okay, if you see this shape, just know this is equal to this. See, the shape is equal to this. Okay. It's not like they are here to make us fail and stuff. No. We have to grab them one by one. Your next thing, when they are put together, now you know, these ones are touching. I know. Okay, this one is equal to this. This one is, And what is your reason here? You say what? What is your reason? Your reason is what? Is opposite, or right, op. Opposite angles of what? Opposite angles of cyclic quad. Okay, we are telling them why these are equal. You say, oh, these angles are opposite angles of cyclic quad. Oh God. Okay. This is your reason. Okay. Let's check the next theorem. Okay. This one says, this one is talking about the tangent, but we have to talk about it. What is a tangent? I think I have to mention this before I get to the actual theorem. Okay. Now, this one is talking about the tangent. Okay. What is a tangent? Tangent is a straight line touching what? Touching a circle at one point. Like this. Okay. At one point. Now, what is going on with this one? Remember, here we are working with angles. Angles are corners. So you need two lines or three lines or four lines to meet at some point to form a corner. And that corner we call it an angle. Right now we don't have angle. So you can't say something going on. We need another thing. Okay, this is not, this is quiet. This has zero knowledge. Okay. So what is going on? They say a line from the center or to a circumference. We know that. If you watch my previous video, you know that is what? A radius. So there is a relationship between this one and the radius. Okay, they meet at point A. There's a relationship between tangent and radius. And that relationship is 90 degrees. Radius meets the tangent in perpendicular or perpendicular. Okay, so you need to know that. You need to know that. You need to know that. Why am I mentioning this? It's because the following theorem needs this idea. Okay? You need to know this. So the tangent theorem says, you have a center here. And now you have what? A tangent. But now it's coming from this side, from point A. This one says, if you have tangents or two tangents coming from the same point, those tangents are what? Are equal in length. Okay? Are equal in length. That's what we are being told. And remember here, what is the relationship between these two? They are 90 degrees. We have to remember that. These ones are 90 degrees. Okay? And 90 degrees. Okay? Are 90 degrees. Okay? This one says, when two tangents are coming from the same points, the length of this is the same. In other words, if this one is 5, this one is 5. If this one is 10, this one is 10. Okay? And look at this. When I put this, you'll see this when we are proving, we are writing proofs. When you put a line here, you end up having just two right-angled triangles. Can you see this one? Mm-hmm. Can you see this one? Mm-hmm. We are having two, but you'll see this when we are proving or we are working with it in a very, very deepest way. Okay. So, that's what we have to know about this one. The length. Okay. Is what? Is the same or is what? Is equal. So, this theorem needs what? Needs you to have tangent. Is the one that we call tan-chord theorem. In other words, the angle is formed by the tangent and the chord. Okay, tangent and chord. Tan-chord theorem. Let's say you have this chord. Okay, look what happened here. Do you see that angle or that corner? Yes. This theorem says the same chord, let me put AB here, this angle outside created by or subtended by chord and tangent or tangent and chord, tangchord theorem, says this angle is equal to the angle that is subtended by the same chord. In other words, as you can see, the chord and theorem. So they created this one. Now they say the same chord will create or will subtend or will form the same angle at the circumference. So in other words, here we have the same angle here. If it's 40 degrees, 40 degrees there. So we have to be able to pay attention to something like that because they are going to trick us a lot here. You will see as time goes on. You will see. Okay, this theorem, you need a center. Okay, you must know which theorem needs a center, okay? Or if I have a center, what relationships? And I have a diameter, okay? It's a diameter. If you watch my previous video, you will know this one. So, if the diameter is what? It's forming an angle here. A, O, B, C. Now, this angle we say is what? We say is 90 degrees. Okay, that is a rule. So even if they put one here or they put one there once, let me just say, an angle that is subtended or created or formed by the diameter at the circumference, just know that one is what? Is 90 degrees, as you can see. Don't worry about it. We'll practice all this. Just I wanted us to look at it one by one so we finish. So then we start looking at the problems, okay? In other words here, angle C is equal to 90 degrees. Okay. It doesn't matter if they split it like this, they put 20 here, they put X here. You stick to that. Hey, I see what we are trying to do. This is X plus 20 is still equal to 90. Then you solve for your X. Okay, so but don't worry, we are going to look at this. And then your reason for this one you say is what? Is we say angle, you say angle in a semicircle. Okay, because it's not a circle, it's a half. Is formed from this side. Okay, this is your reason for you to say this is 90. Okay. Okay, grade 11s, those are the basics I just wanted us to go through before we do question papers, we try exercises, examples and stuff. So now you will know that I once mentioned this. I can't just come with a question paper now. We don't even know what's going on, where it's coming from, why this is that. So from now on, we are going to pay attention to question papers and stuff and see what's going on. So thank you for watching. If you liked or you learned something, please like and follow my page on TikTok And follow me on TikTok. If you're not following me, subscribe. If you're not subscribing, please comment. If you are not subscribing, you are not following. Thank you so much. Hope you like the video. Thanks.